Good morning, students. How are you today? Teacher Collins again, this time in social studies. We want to look at the San Andreas Fault. The San Andreas Fault. This fault is found in the western part of the United States of America. Now, this is our cardinal point. North, south, east, west. So, the San Andreas Fault is found in the western, this is South America. So, USA is somewhere there. All this part is USA. And it is found in the western part. So, it is found this way. The fault line that is here, that occupies the environment, is the St. Andreas Fault. The St. Andreas Fault. So, what is a fault? A fault is a large crack or a break in a series of rocks. In a series of rocks, that is, when rocks have cracked and they break right down, that is called a fault. We can see a fault line. If we go to volcanic mountain, we see rocks that are break, and we see the line of the rock, of the break, of the crack, very long, and it goes inside. That is an example of a fault. It is called a fault. So, we want to look at St. Andreas Fault. We said the rock on both sides of the fall will slip up and down each other. What does that mean? If this is a rock and there is a breakage here, it means at this point one may slip down and then it continues. So one may fall inside or in the fall, it can have a crack, an opening, and then the other one to continue this way. So this part, when we have that crack in the rock, is a fault. And like we said, the earth crust or the earth is made up of layers, four layers. So let's say this is a sample of the earth crust that we have created. And then this part is the crack. And we notice that if this one falls down, and this one will remain also, there will be a kind of a small, either a steep sloping wall here, and then since this one will fall this way, there will be a kind of a steep wall here, and this is the fault line. That is the fault line. So the St. Andreas Fault is found in the western part of United States. And we notice that most of where we have this fault line, we have volcanic mountains. They may have one or two volcanic mountains. And what is a volcanic mountain? It is a mountain which is formed by volcanic activity, that is the rise of magma up to the surface, and it falls back and form a mountain. And when it falls and it is forming that mountain, now they will call it lava. But in here at the place of deposit is called magma. We are still come to that, when we shall be treating for Kano. So, in this St. Andrews or St. Andreas fall, earthquake always occur. And sometimes the earthquake is very intense and severe around the fall. It's very intense and severe around the fall. Why? Because it is at that breakage where the place where the land grants, where the rocks that are vibrating there, the rocks that are trembling there, the rocks begin to fall apart. They begin to fall apart, and you know, when a rock falls, it might push the other one, or because of the movement, as there is the breakage, there is high pressure at that area that will cause more, an intensity, a higher intensity in the earthquake. So, I gave us a definition for earthquake in our last class. I said earthquake are sudden shaking or sudden tremor, we call them tremor, of the earth surface. When the earth surface begins to vibrate, it begins to vibrate, it begins to shake. Even the buildings that are around, if it happens around the building, it might even cause a crack in the building and the building will collapse. That is an earthquake. So, this is an exception of the St. Andreas fault, where it is found and how the line is, and this area is a focal point of earthquake activity, and in that area we have dotted volcanic mountain, dotted volcanic, or there are some few volcanic mountains in the area. So we move next to volcanoes. Volcanoes. What is a volcano? What is a volcano? A volcano is a hollow or a tear and weak spots in the earth crust, a hollow or a tear and weak spots in the earth crust, where gases, hot magma, and other molten rocks flow out of the earth crust, flow out of the earth crust. Now, why do we say they are weak areas? Take for example, let's look at this sample of the earth crust. If there is magma deposit here, it becomes red hot. Now, because of this magma deposit here, there is high pressure. It begins to eat up the land, trying to force its way out. And as it is breaking the rocks, if it meets a very hard rock here, the magma may also pump its waves and go to where there is a softer rock and continue to break. If it meets a hard rock here, it might break its way this way and continue until it gets to the surface. So it breaks by the area which are softer. So, most often a hill or a mountain are formed around volcano. Why do they form a hill? Because when the lava leaves, let's assume this is the layers of the earth. When the lava leaves or the magma leaves the inner part of the earth surface, and it forces its way out, normally it comes out with explosion. This route that the magma takes to go out is called the vent. And then, where if it gets to the surface, because of the high pressure, it will explode out with the gases and small, small rock and dust particles going up. And then the magma starts flowing. It starts flowing. It starts flowing. Very red hot. As it is flowing, when it goes down, it cools and solidifies. As it solidifies there, it forms what? A mountain or a hill. A mountain or a hill. And this is called a volcanic mountain. This is called a volcanic mountain. Volcanic mountain. And what is a volcanic mountain? A volcanic mountain is a mountain that is formed through volcanic activities like the deposition of lava from the air crust. So, the molten rocks, the molten rocks and smoke, dust and ash particles that escape from the mantle, the core, the inner core and part of the outer core in the air crust is being forced out. It's being forced out because it is hot, that it has pressure looking for means to release the heat. It is that pressure from the heat in the rock that path its way, that break the rock to open way for it to come out. So, that is an aspect of volcano. And this rock inside the air crust, which is molten, it means the rock has been heated and then it has melted and very thick. So it becomes more of a very thick liquid. It's called a molten rock. Molten. Molten rock. And when it starts going out through the vent, at the mouth of this vent is called a crater. Crater. So when it goes out through the vent and gets to the crater, it begins to flow outside, it forms a mountain. And when it starts flowing outside, this one is called the lava. Lava is the magma that flows out through the vent and crater and then solidifies to form a volcanic mountain or a hill. And solidifies it to form a volcanic mountain or a hill. So, beloved students, that is how a volcanic mountain is being formed, or volcanic activities are being formed. As we go higher, we are going to get a detailed explanation on the different activities that are different processes that occur during a volcano. Thank you very much. Read your notes. Follow up the lectures and then do the exercises and send back to school. God bless you. Bye-bye.